I believe in our guys, and I think we just have to keep being optimistic and positive and, you know, approach the game like we did, you know, Friday and Saturday night at UNH. I was very pleased and proud of our team, overcoming some obstacles, obviously, and, you know, I thought we banded together very well, bonded well, and, you know, obviously we've got a lot to play for over the next 2 weekends, and we just take it one shift at a time. And if we play with that kind of energy and everybody playing to their role and up to their abilities, we'll be a good team when it's all said and done.
You know, we're trying not to think about, we're in ninth place right now. You know, teams in front of us might have a game in hand or something like that. But, you know, right now it's just simply one game at a time. And I mean, you know, you hear it over and over, but that's the only way you can really look at it. You know, go out, play your game the best you can, and take it one step at a time and hope for the best.
We get down four different times against New Hampshire on Friday night, despite playing excellent hockey. We always came back. Next night, we got completely dominated in the first period. We're down 2-0, and we claw our way back. So there's no give up on you know, on this team right now. I think they realize that there's four important games ahead of us. A lot of points still left on the board, especially when you consider the standings right now and how crazy they are in the league. I think our guys are just filled with optimism, and hey, whatever comes our way, we'll tackle it at that time and, you know, be stronger for it.
Coach has been talking about the process, and I know it's a little late in the season to be thinking that there's positives to come out of taking 1 point out of a two-game weekend, but if you look at the process, we did put together two of the best games we've had all year, and we just got to start turning that into points. I mean, nobody's thinking the season's over. We're still looking. We want home ice. We want playoffs here in the gut, you know. So nobody's rolling over here. We're ready to go here.
Well, I think they're playing much better second half than they were first half, as their record indicates. They've had some tough moments as well, though. I mean, they dropped a game to Providence last weekend. They almost dropped both, but came back in the third period at home to salvage, you know, 2 points out of the weekend. They're an excellent team. You know, obviously, they got a lot of players back from last year's national championship team, and we've got our work cut out for us. They're going to be a great opponent, but it's a great opportunity for us, you know, to rise to the challenge and try to earn some points on Friday night. So we're looking forward to it.
I mean, I think with, you know, you kind of see it a lot with teams, you know, when there's injuries and other things going on that, you know, guys kind of pull together. And I think you really could see that with the fact that we gave up a goal 20 seconds in. You think it could have just crushed us. And we turned around and played pretty solid week.
I think when you get into those situations, you know, there's so many different variables right now that you're losing focus on what you can control, and that's how we play, and, you know, we control our own destiny right now. So I think if you start worrying about scenarios, you're missing the chance to focus on what really counts. So we won't be talking a lot about that with our team. I mean, the one thing we've talked about, you know, over the last couple of weeks is just being optimistic about the situation that's in front of us and not worry about opportunities missed, you know, from the past. We can't do anything about it. So we still have a lot of reason left to play, both in conference and certainly on the national level if we take care of business over the next, you know, 2 or 3 weeks.